Hi, I'm Randy Robison. This is Life Today TV. I have the author of the new book, Dirty God. A very provocative title and imagery, nasty feet on the cover. Johnny Moore's with me. Johnny, thanks for being here.
Yeah, it's good to be with you, Randy.
And on the show, you're going to talk about the content of the book. So you have to watch Life Today to catch all the content of the book, which is worth watching, I should add. But I want to ask you about the cover, because it's got some really... See it, some really nasty, gnarly.
There are even blisters on there, cuts and blood and all that stuff.
Not attractive.
No.
Not attractive. And yet, supposedly, those are the feet of Jesus. They at least represent them, obviously.
Yeah, and actually, it's pretty close. And that was kind of my point in the book. I wanted to get to the gritty human side of Jesus. And what better way to represent that than a guy who lived in the Middle East 2,000 years ago that wore sandals in the Judean sun? And so that's probably what Jesus' feet looked like sometimes.
Probably a little rough, yeah. So there you go.
Dirty God.
Dirty God. Definitely check that out. Let me ask you this. Did you know, this is just an aside, this is bonus to the bonus, right? And maybe this is in your book. You know, Jesus' first miracle.
Yeah.
Turn the water into wine.
Mm-hmm.
You know where he got the water?
No.
It was the cisterns that they washed people's feet with coming
really?
To the party.
I wish I'd have known that before I wrote the book.
Sorry, we should have talked sooner.
I should have started the book that way.
But and then they said, hey, you saved the best wine for last. And what a picture of the dirtiness of humanity that turns into the best, you know, wine of the Spirit.
I think I need to interview you.
Yeah, well.
You know stuff like that.
I should put that in my book since it's not in your book. Okay, I want to talk to you about, you are the campus pastor and vice president of Liberty University. And as an ORU grad, it pains me to say it, but it's true. It also pleases me to say it because Christian universities. But Liberty has really done a lot of things right in the last decade or so. What's kind of the vibe out there right now?
You know, the vision for Liberty from the very beginning was to be for evangelicals, what Brigham Young and Notre Dame are for Mormons and for Catholics. So to have all the amenities of a major state school, all the athletic programs and facilities and academic programs, but to do it in an environment that was openly and profoundly and committed to the Bible, to the Word of God. So we're a university that is not a Bible school. We're a liberal arts university with 300 programs of study, a medical school coming on board, a law school. I mean, literally 300 programs of study. And yet every one of our classes begin in prayer. All of our professors believe the Bible is the Word of God, that Jesus is the Son of God. They're all on one-year contracts so that if they decide that they're not going to be, you know, biblicist anymore, they can go teach at lots of other universities. But at Liberty University, we believe that God, the author of all knowledge, ought to be at the heart of the educational process. So it's not that you don't get everything else. You get everything else. You know, we teach everything you'd learned at any other school. It's just that we teach that plus what we believe undergirds it all in this Christ-centered environment.
I know when I was in school, the reputation of Liberty was hardline Baptist, ultra-conservative, right-wing fundamental kind of place.
Yeah.
I don't get that anymore.
No.
Has that been intentional?
Yeah, well, the vision for Liberty was always for evangelicals. So while it was founded from a Baptist church and while it, you know, reflected its that identity early on. I mean, now, actually, what people don't realize is 60% of Liberty University students aren't Baptist. They're evangelicals of every other, you know, denomination and almost every way you can characterize them. So Liberty really has become the university for evangelicals. So when you attend our convocation, which we have three times a week, 80 guest speakers a year that are the most famous Christian leaders and leaders, period, across the board, you know, the worship feels charismatic.
Really?
You know, the Bible, some of the Bible teachers, you know, might teach like Bible church people or Baptist people, but you know, the leaders of all the major denominations come and speak at Liberty. But you also hear from people like Donald Trump, from the CEO of Walmart, these cultural figures that we believe our students should be exposed to so they can make their own minds up about the ideas that are prevalent in our culture. So yeah, it really is true that you can't say Liberty University fits in this evangelical box. The university was meant to serve the whole church, and it's doing it.
Mm-hmm. How many students are you running now?
We have over 84,000 online. Goodness. And then on our Lynchburg, Virginia campus, we have 12,200 studying on our 6,000-acre campus.
Now, online, what does that mean? You got people getting degrees from Liberty without ever going to Virginia?
Yeah, I mean, you can if you want to, but you don't have to. So this is unbelievable. I mean, this is a university with nearly 100,000 students. It's the world's largest Christian university. Mm-hmm. And so while the students that are studying on our residential campus fit the mold of a typical university student, 18 to 22, it's normal university life, the average online student is married, they have a family, they have a job, they're in their mid-30s or early 40s, and they're finishing the bachelor's degree they never finished, or getting an associate's degree to, you know, learn something they wanted to learn, or getting a master's degree so they can get a raise at their job. And so you can literally study in almost any program that we offer at the university, but you can do it at home at your computer. And if you want to have the university experience, well, you can come to campus for week-long intensives. You can study in our library. We say we're a university that's both brick and click. You know, most online universities are just online.
Right.
But we have, you know, at Liberty University, we're finishing our $50 million library that serves both residential and online students. And so, yeah, our online program is truly innovative in higher education across the board. In fact, it just a couple weeks ago prompted the Washington Post to do a cover story on Liberty University.
Really?
They called us the evangelical mega university, an almost entirely positive article praising our Christian university's innovation in higher education, Christian
or
otherwise.
Nice. You guys are well-funded now.
Yeah, we are. We believe in capitalism at Liberty, unashamedly. So, I mean, our name is Liberty University. And so we believe that a student's education is valuable if the university survives.
Right.
And so, you know, one of the notable characteristics of a university is, for instance, your net assets. That's how much cash and buildings and everything that you have. And, you know, end of last year, we reached $1 billion in net assets. That's like equivalent to Georgetown University.
Nice.
See, we believe if it's Christian, it ought to be better. You shouldn't give us a break because we're Christian. The vision 41 years ago was to have this world-class institution of higher education.
Yeah.
And now people in every corner of the globe are noticing. And it's a university where you know that 30, 40 years from now, your degree is going to matter because we actually believe in managing our fiscal house. You know, but by the way, you know, when you start talking about things like that, people always ask, well, what about financial aid and all these things? We have a robust financial aid program for students, online or residential, and our loan default rate, which means, you know, students that don't pay back their loans, is one of the lowest default rates in the country, which tells us that our students are
getting
jobs,
right.
Their degrees matter,
right.
They're able to pay back their loans. And
it just works out
for everybody.
They probably have the moral fiber and character to want to pay back their loans, too.
Actually, that's what the purpose of Christian education is, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, I actually believe that if we had more Liberty University graduates in places of influence all across the world, then we would have the prevalence of Christian ethics.
Right.
You know, some people think that what we're trying to do is kind of revolutionary, this Christian university that's not a Bible school. But we actually think it's vintage. We think this is the way higher education was started in the United States.
Yeah, it was.
So
it was.
And it wouldn't hurt to have more ethics on Wall Street and on Main Street.
You're probably more like the original Ivy League schools than the Ivy League schools are today.
Yeah, you know, sometimes they say the difference between our students and their students is you can walk through their hallway. Their students walk through their hallways, and they don't know who's on that portrait or featured in that statue.
Yeah.
But our students know the pastors and missionaries that founded their schools.
Yeah,
and so they can deny that God ought to not be at the center of the educational process, but they'd have to carve out the Bible verses that are etched in stone all over their campuses.
Yeah.
And
so
God is welcome at Liberty University.
Nice. And this has all been recently under the leadership of Jerry Falwell, Jr.
Jerry Falwell, Jr., our chancellor, is a really remarkable, remarkable leader. He's an alumnus of the university. His kids either have attended or are attending our high school or our college. One is an alumnus of Liberty. One's attending. One's in our high school. So he knows what Liberty was like as a student. He knows how Liberty is as a parent. And having worked at the university 20 years before his father passed and he took over, he really had the foundation to lead the university into the next generation.
Mm-hmm.
So since he became chancellor in 2007, we've gone from maybe 40,000 online students to over 80,000. We've gone from 7,000 residentially to over 12,000. And it just is going. And that matters too. But what's most interesting about Jerry is he's a real humble guy. And so our chancellor leads a billion-dollar organization, a massive organization, and yet you'll find him sitting at games with students, helping them unload their car. He invites all the senior class over to his farm every May before they graduate.
Wow.
He and his wife are really parents to Liberty, and that sets the whole community up.
Yeah, no, I think you can judge by the fruit, you know, and the fruit is good. So congrats to you guys out there. The website for Liberty, people who want to check it out for their kids, for themselves.
Yeah, you can go to liberty.edu. You can learn all the latest news and happenings at the university. You can inquire if you want to be an online or a residential student. One of the most unusual things we're having now is we're having freshman college students begin college at the same time their parents start college again online. Uh-huh. And so they have this shared experience. And yeah. So yeah, go to liberty.edu and you're going to find that what I've said is just part of the story. There's so much more to the story. There's no place like Liberty.
Very, very cool. Appreciate what you're doing, because the education system right now, especially higher education in our country, it really is a mess. I mean, in a lot of respects, it's a joke. Hmm. I've got a daughter in college, you know, at Baylor, good school. Son who's graduating. And so I've been checking into it. And man, as a Christian parent, the more you look at it, you go, do I really want to spend this money or get into debt or saddle my kid with debt to learn stuff I need to unteach them at the end of their time, you know?
Yeah, so, I mean, you think you raise your child your whole life and you instill all these values, and then you turn them to a secular institution with professors that are going to deconstruct all of that intentionally.
No, it doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense at all, and that's why we believe in higher education and Christian higher education.
Right.
Whether it's Liberty or whether it's another great Christian school, you ought to have your kids in Christian education.
I think so too, in at least in something that doesn't contradict your values, because it's hard sometimes because you want your kids to learn, you know, business or, you know, whatever specialty area that they're in. And so you think, well, we got to put up with the anti-Christian bent in order for them to get a good degree in the field in which they need. But you guys are saying, no, you don't.
No, we're intentional about that. Yeah. We say it's as important for you to know why other people know, why other people believe what they believe, as why you believe what you believe.
Yeah.
So we're going to teach it all to you because we actually believe in the marketplace of ideas, that our ideas stand, and so we don't have to be intimidated by everybody else's ideas. And so, you know, that's one of the great misnomers about Christian education. It's not that you get anything less, it's that you just get something more.
And at the end of the day, it all comes back to what you believe as an institution, and, you know, what you uphold as the truth, instead of saying, well, make up your own truth. This is what we believe the truth is. Commend you for that. All the guys out there, everybody that I've met a lot of people, you know, from university over the last few years, all of them have been very quality, strong, smart people, and that I continue to be impressed by what's coming out of Liberty. So good to know you, and congrats to all that's going on out there. Check out Liberty for yourself, for your kids, and other than that, just be encouraged by what they're doing out there. Pray for these guys out of Liberty, because you know, changing our kids and getting the Word of God back into them changes the culture, so it's important. Check out Dirty God bookstores right now, and watch Johnny on Life Today at lifetoday.org. Thanks again for being here.
Thank you.